a journey, traveling the country and experiencing creativity and art demonstrations. And now, we're live in a city near you, whoever you might be. It's the Kraaft It Live Art Concert, an art show with fun, laughter, and a few mistakes thrown in too. Follow along on Instagram and see behind-the-scenes images by D-Dog. Fielding your YouTube questions, Sylvia and Mr. Crafter. And now, your host, Heather Crafter.
So are we live? All right, checking. It looks like my mic says we're live, and I got the thumbs up from D-Dog, so we should be here. Hello, welcome to Kraaft It Live. Can you hear me, Sylvia? No? All right. Well, it is another Tuesday afternoon, depending on where you're at, I suppose. And we are excited to be back in the studio again for Kraaft Shaak, and we're doing Kraaft It Live. All right. I got the thumbs up from everybody. We're good to go now. Okay, so I am working with PanPastels all month in February here, so this is kind of exciting. This is a few technical difficulties. It's so hilarious. I'm sure out in the audience you guys are going, what is her problem? But, you know, it's so funny to see the two of them doing sign language and stuff. Okay, I'm sorry. Composure. And he rips the headset off. Okay. See, now, if you were here at an art concert in person with us, you would get to experience all of this fun that we're having that you miss because the camera's here and not on that. Anyway, so next week we might possibly have someone here in the audience with us. That'll be kind of exciting. If Sylvia was here, she would, I mean, she is here, but if she was like with me. So did you hear what I said?
I can hear.
All right, can they hear her yet?
Can you guys hear me?
Okay. So did you hear what I said? Next week we're going to have a visitor?
Huh?
It's possible. I know, shocking.
I'm getting a delay here.
Oh, there's so much fun going on. Oh, so much fun. Okay, so, so Sylvia.
Yes, dear.
we might possibly.
I answer you that's talking or what I'm hearing in my head.
Yeah, well, what the things you hear in your head are also me speaking to you.
It's voices,
just,
you know.
Yeah, it's just a delay. Anyway, so next week we might possibly have a visitor.
Yes, we oh, that was my cue. Yes, we are going to have a visitor next week. Nikki's going to be here.
Well, maybe. We weren't going to say who.
Oh,
all right.
Forget what I said.
Never mind.
We're going to have an unknown visitor.
Unknown, who may or may not be named Nikki. Okay, so here's the thing. Okay, I'm just going to move on over to our message.
Oh, they have an echo. They're hearing an echo.
Of course they're hearing an echo because we're like going crazy over here.
Okay, can you
He'll fix it.
Can you take the hearing off and just give me my mic?
Okay. All right, we're going to do today's message. I'm going to read it. Is that okay? For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah 29:11. That's today's message. So just wanted to share that's one of my, you're mad because I did it?
That was my message,
she says.
I'm going to do it anyway. For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. And I love that. I don't know if any of you are Sign, Field, and Deliver fans on the Hallmark Channel, but that was one of the verses etched into a cornerstone of a church in one of the episodes, and I thought it was an absolutely gorgeous verse. And it happens to be Heather's favorite.
Well, I was going to say this is my favorite. I'm trying so hard to keep from laughing. It is one of my favorite verses, my absolute favorite verse, actually, because, and T, you don't have to hang on the message there if you don't want to, because I really do feel like that's how, that's like my, what do you call it? What do you call that message? My heart song or something. I don't know what you call that, but because I feel like that's what's given me direction every day. I mean, I know that God has plans for me. I know that there's a hope and a future for me. And because of that, I'm able to get up even when I feel like I'm dying, like it was this weekend, but we're good. We have answers to where we are with all that junk, and now we can...
While you're gathering all your stuff, I want to say hi to everybody.
Oh, would you please say hello to the audience? That'd be awesome.
So Jules is here, and Kim is here, and Michael Ann, and I'll think of a name for you soon, Michael Ann. And Nikki's here, and Andrew was here, and Sandra's here.
So Nikki's here?
Nikki's here.
All right. Sorry to have announced Nikki, but now you have no choice. You must come. There's no choice about it.
I'm scrolling just to make sure I haven't forgotten anybody.
All right, that's good. I'm so grateful that there are people here joining us live for this crazy antics that we call Kraaft It Live Art Concert. T-Dog is now putting in his two-week notice, and he's going backwards 2 weeks on that. So I guess today's his last day, everybody.
Is that me? Are they looking at me?
Who said that, Andrew?
That was Andrew.
Yeah, that had
and
to have been Andrew.
Says, Sylvia sounds like she's in a cave. I am in a cave, honey. I'm in the art cave.
Oh, my goodness. What an absolute great way to start the day. Absolute great way. All right. So we are still working on Bryce Canyon.
Yes.
Is this auto-adjusting now?
Oh. I would have liked that. Oh.
Okay, T-Dog's fired.
You have Fire TV. I think that's from Amazon. I'm not really sure. But apparently Bryce Canyon is one of the screensavers, and Sandra brought that to our attention today. So Sandra's out in the audience, and she's going to be,
yeah,
well,
she's
the
watching,
virtual audience.
She's watching on her TV.
Yes. Oh, that's right. She's watching on her TV. And so she is going to be guiding Heather as she goes along.
Yeah, so she'll let me know if I really messed it up. The hoodoos, yeah. I don't think we're going to finish today. Does anybody want to take bets? Maybe we'll finish next week.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
We'll see.
Yeah. And Sandra says, Sylvia, you sound like you're hiding you inside a box.
Sylvia in a box. That's today's episode's title.
You'd be surprised where they've got me, guys. Help me.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. He's going to turn the camera around so they can see where you really are, he said. That's against the rule.
Heather has finally trapped Sylvia and put her in a tube.
Yeah, that's against the rules. I'm not allowed to show where Sylvia is. That was all part of our agreement.
Oh, Heather's begun, everybody.
Yeah, big deal. Nobody cares. They didn't come here to see this anyway. All right, so I'm going to just go in here and add these, our hoodoos, like we did before.
Is that the same color you used before?
I have no idea. Why would you ask me that question? Who do the voodoo that you do? So all I'm doing
BJ's
is adding.
Hi, BJ.
Oh, hi, BJ.
And
we're so glad you're here.
Say hi.
Or yeah.
Hi, Abe.
Yeah, well, you know. Yeah, who said that, by the way? Who said that? Oh, of course it was Andrew. And Jazzy's here?
Yeah.
Oh, Jazzy, we haven't seen you in a while. I'm so glad you're here. So every last couple of days, maybe it was a couple of days ago, I don't know, because I've been dying, if I haven't mentioned that yet or not. But I get a notification that Jazzy's on Instagram. How do I know? Because Jazzy's liked like 27 things or something. So it's kind of cool. I love it when that happens. I feel like in that moment, I wish that I could reach out to them and say, I'm here too.
Yeah.
Hi. Yay, a friend. Come, be with me for a moment, please. All right, this is looking boring and flat.
Oh, that's so cool. Sandra says, Sylvia, the voice of Oz behind the curtain. Yes, this is Oz speaking.
So is it really still weird, your sound? Are they saying it's improved at all, or no? Oh, I don't know if you guys heard or not, but T-Dog put in his 2-week notice, and he retroactively put it in for 2 weeks ago now. So we're kind of without.
Andrew commented about that too. He said, "Neat, a retroactive 2-week notice. How creative!" Well. He is part of the craft shop.
Right? Yeah. No. Creativity is his middle name. Or his mother will add it to his birth certificate. All right. I'm using a totally different sponge for this part, and I don't know that I like how it looks. You see the total difference here between these and the rest of them? I don't like it. We're going back. Let's go back. Well, okay, to be fair, none of us were prepared today. So why should you get a show that looks prepared? We don't want you to be confused about that. Am I blocking it?
No.
Standing here? No. Oh, good. It feels like I'm right in front of the painting and you guys can't see.
No, that's actually on a good angle.
That's excellent camera skills by T-Dog. You know, honestly, T, if you left, I don't think we'd be able to do this show,
I really can't leave.
Able
to handle what he does.
No. So I'm sorry, but your 2-week notice has been declined. I believe I have a bunch of witnesses who say it's not acceptable. Yeah, I don't even need a paper shredder. I just denied it, period, the end. Ask everyone watching, will they accept it? I like that. We'll all watch that, too. All right, what I just realized here is that these are all like the same height, and I don't like that, so I'm fixing that. Why don't I pay attention to what I'm doing? That might be a good idea. So we should actually talk about PanPastels a little bit. What do you think about that? Is that a good idea? Oh, T's got the phone out. That means he's taking Instagram pictures. Hey, you know what I didn't do? I forgot to get the resource photo. I don't have the resource photo out. And I don't know that you'll be able to find it on my iPad.
Nikki says, God help us if this turns into a job I need to help with.
All of a sudden, she's not coming next week. Well, that's weird.
Oh, we have things for you, Nikki.
Well, the things we have for her to do are pretty fun, though. No actual jobs. Okay, here we go. Look, I'm starting to paint now. I don't know what time it is, but now I'm starting to paint. Like, I've just calmed down a little bit enough that I can actually start to paint now. And these ones up front here have to be more detailed. Like, you know, like this, they have to be more detailed than this stuff back here.
I have confidence. Je suis confiant en vous.
Whoa. What? Huh?
Oh, T's taking pictures.
That means Instagram, you guys. If you are not familiar with the show, I am really sorry that this is the one you stumbled upon.
It says it's going to shut me down.
Oh, we're about to lose Sylvia. Anyway, if this is the first time you've watched the show, I first off, I apologize. Secondly, we do this thing on Instagram where T-Dog takes pictures, behind the scenes, close-up shots, stuff like that, and you get to see some pretty cool things that you don't get to see live. Because it just doesn't look the same on a streaming camera. You know? Am I right?
T-Dog's taking pictures. Hey, he did a behind the scenes. He's not supposed to do a behind the scenes. He's getting me back. I know he is.
I think that's that one. I think it was me. The one you're talking about was me. I did that. Just, yeah, that's...
On Instagram, Nikki posted this really great quote, and I just think it's beautiful. She wrote, she's from Vincent Van Gogh, and it says, "The more I think about it, the more I realize there is nothing more artistic than to love others."
Aww.
Isn't that beautiful?
That is beautiful. Yeah, you can always win with a Van Gogh quote for sure.
And I don't see Lynn's here today.
That's several weeks in a row now without our Lynn's. Where is she? Somebody needs to reach out.
And she's been doing some absolutely hysterical hammies, so if you guys don't follow her, you need to follow her.
Yeah, if you don't follow her, there's something wrong. Like, obviously, we don't have a link available for you or something, because seriously, the woman is incredibly talented. If you don't know that already, Lynn's is a resident cartoonist. She does all of the cartoon artwork that you've seen here on Kraaft Shaak, on our website and in our videos, and she does all that. That's her. We take no credit for that.
Yeah, she's amazing.
So, my friend has been going and asking us to do something.
Ready, Teddy, Freddy?
Yeah.
Well, tell him we're waiting for him, so.
I don't know what he's doing. He's doing something else. But he was going to ask Lynn to do a cartoon or something that he's thinking of.
And wouldn't that be cool? Yeah. Well, we'll get them connected. We will. All right, I'm starting to like this. It's starting to talk to me a little bit here.
Really good.
Okay, so I don't know if you guys paid any attention to this, because, I mean, this being an art show and stuff, we sometimes do a little bit of art here. I take these darker colors.
Oh, Lisa's here.
Hi, Lisa.
She's watching on her phone. She wishes
awesome.
She was home. And Michael Lamb said that she finally found Hammy on Facebook, which is great because he's on Facebook too. But she has her own website now called harryfarmersdaughter.co.uk.
Yeah.
And she has a newsletter that you can sign up for.
Oh, my gosh. Once a month newsletter chocked full of stuff that makes – it would take you a whole week to read everything in there. And it's an artist's delight. I mean, the things, the tips she has, the little blurbs she puts out, oh, my goodness.
And then she talks about Hammy's little adventures of where he's gone.
Yep.
And oh, it's just an amazing newsletter, so you need to sign up for that.
Yeah, you really do. You really do. And she doesn't want to spam you. She wants to make it something that you'll enjoy and you'll really benefit from. And she really puts a heart and soul into what she's doing. So please check that out. Please, please, please. All right, so what I started to say was that taking these darker colors here, and including black, which you don't see me doing, so I don't hold that one in my hand, but I'm just putting them on the end here. And then I'm going in around these marks that I made earlier to bring them out. So all of a sudden they stop looking like, I don't know. Right now they kind of look like ladyfingers. You know those bread cookie things?
Those bread cookie things?
The bread, they're like a soft cookie, ladyfingers.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. They kind of look like that.
Yeah.
Okay, so then when we go in, everything relates to food.
I'm hungry.
I know, everything relates to food with me. Okay, so when I go in and I can now carve this out a little bit with those dark colors, do you see how I'm doing that? Now I can give it shape, more like the hoodoo. See how I'm doing that? And it's given like the little bit of, now this one stands alone. whereas before it was smooshed in with the rest. So that's what we're going to work on today, is making some of these a little bit more defined hoodoos. And I can make them have layers.
Yeah, she said that she went to her site, but she can't find her newsletter, but it's located way down at the bottom. You got to scroll down there.
Yeah, you really got to hunt for it. I had to ask the slave to give me a link to it. Yep. Yeah. I had to ask for special treatment, and I got kind of yelled at by it, but it was okay. I got over it. Because I said the same thing. I couldn't find it either, Michael Ann. All right, now I've got like a sharper tool. So these tools are all different. I don't know if we talked about this before, but I'm going to just show you these tools here real quick. PanPastel has some really great tools. They call these soft, S-O-F-F-T. Wonder why I like them. Two Fs. They put two Fs in their name. These are soft tools, and they are like palette knives type with sponges on the end, and they have four different shapes. And like this one is a number one, so it's sort of like a round filbert style paintbrush. And then this one's like a flat. This one is more like a palette knife with this triangle tip, and then this one is like a round brush, okay? So it's one, two, the round one is three, and the triangle is four. Not that any of that matters. All I'm trying to tell you is there's these four different shapes, and with those shapes you can do different things. And so I'm going to use the round one with that same color on the back, and now I can get in here and do even more details and get little sharper images. And I can go into these dark crevices here where it's like, you know, the deep recesses of this crevice right there. And see how I've just carved this shape out? Can you see that?
Yeah.
I'm just carving that shape out. No longer does it look like a big lady finger anymore. Now it's starting to look like those shapes. And for those of you who may not have seen before, this is the resource picture. Thank you, T-Dog, for picking up my resource image for me, but you can start to see why I'm having to carve out some of those images. See how they've got like these weird jagged shapes? Mm-hmm. Well, these aren't weird jagged shapes. They're more like flat bricks or ladyfinger shapes, but now they're starting to take some of those jagged edges, as you see there. Okay? So it's almost like I'm carving away at the stone with the dark. And then I can go in and I can add more color if I want to in places. So it's not looking so much like it's black back in there, because it's really not in my image. See how that does? That's kind of cool, right? Yeah, we'll just keep going.
On the screen, it just made those pop.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. That's what your behind-the-scenes pictures are. So T-Dog says he wishes he could zoom in, but it zoomed about as far as it'll go. Well, yeah, I'm not picking this thing up and bringing it to the... That won't work. It's too big. So some of these areas you can probably see are a little bit, what's the word? I'll let you take that picture. It's like I've just dabbed the chalk on, you know, I don't know what the word is, but it just doesn't look blended. Mm-hmm. Okay, so taking that tool, any tool, really, and just lightly touching the surface, and it blends it right in. We'll do that over here with this one. Do you see how this one has... You want me to sit still for a minute?
Yeah. T-Dog's getting a picture of it before she blends it.
All right, and then I'm just going to go in and lightly blend that out, and it won't be so obtrusive to the eye. See, whereas before it was like that's where your eye would go. Now it's just sort of a part of the painting. And that was just using the sponge and just lightly blending it.
Such a light touch.
Yep, you just got to be very light with it, that's all. And anywhere you don't like it, you're kind of almost erasing it a little bit. It's like you're erasing what you don't like. Just bring those lighter colors over, just like that. Mm. Like this part in here, do you see how choppy that looks? That's the word I was looking to say before, choppy. I can just go in here and sort of blend that out a little bit. You have to be careful because if you didn't put enough paint, but if you didn't put enough of the pigment on to begin with, then what you're blending out is just to paper. So then you just have to add more, but that
looks
pretty good.
It looks a little rounded now.
Yeah. Yeah, so it's much more like a crevice. Mm-hmm. Where the light has sort of disappeared into, and that's exactly what we're seeing in our paint, in our picture that we took, is that the light isn't hitting that area. Mm-hmm. So hopefully that's coming across on screen for you guys. I don't know if do we still
yeah,
have any viewers?
A great job with the pictures.
Awesome.
Wonderful.
If we still have viewers, we haven't lost everybody due to our crazy antics. All right, so we're just going to go in and sort of add some of those character traits to some of these things back here. Just a little bit of those defining marks.
I think Kim said she was watching on her phone, so now she's taking it to the kitchen because she's hungry.
Oh. Well, what are you making us, Kim? I think we are all hungry. It's that time of day. T's placing his order. Yeah. So those of you who have been watching on Instagram probably know that yesterday I was not feeling so good, and it carried over from last week. And it's really a carryover from what happened last month. As you may remember, I was had lots of coughing and all kinds of terrible things. We thought, oh no, does she have the flu? I mean, everybody was so concerned, and I was really grateful for all of the prayers and everything that I've gotten so much from all that. But it turns out I have severe allergies, and Arizona wants to kill me. And so rather than moving, although that is what I originally wanted to do, eventually we will when we get on the road, but rather than moving right now to get away from it, I got a shot, an allergy shot that I think I'm way better than I was yesterday, so it must be working so far.
More
I also, I am more better.
More better. Oh, chili. She's having chili. And Andrew said she's making horsey doovers.
Horsey doovers for everyone, I hope. That's funny. But yeah, so just doing so much better thanks to figuring out what in the world is wrong with me, but who'd have thunk? I lived in Arizona my whole life, moved to Butte, Montana 14 years ago, and then, you know, when I come to visit, I've had issues, but I've never visited long enough to where it turned me into the sick dog I've been. So that was kind of an eye-opener, big time. So I'm liking how those are turning out. They're looking much more like our statuesque.
Hoodoos. T-Dog just posted a new picture up on Instagram.
Oh, you guys.
The coloring is spot on. It's spot on. It looks so good. So if you want to see what it actually looks like. Because I know everybody's monitor shows it differently, but it's an excellent picture, T-Dog. Excellent.
So that's awesome. Thank you, T, for taking those pictures. I can't wait to see. I always have to wait till the show's over. I never get to see any of this work he does until the show's over.
Well, you're looking at the real thing, sweetheart.
Yeah, but I mean, big deal. What he does with the camera is so awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, excuse me. I'm going to take a minute and take a look. Thank you. Oh, wow. You did a great job of the colors. Yeah, you did. Wow. So now in that picture, you can see all the different colors that I'm using. It's not just a boring palette, huh?
Yeah, it's a great shot.
Well, we don't always get things configured right. It doesn't matter. People are okay with it, bud. You did good.
Michael Ann says where she lives it's snowing, and then where Kim lives it's raining.
Oh, wow.
We've had that for the last, 3 days of rain? 2 days, 3 days, something like that?
Yeah, all of last week it was beautiful rain. I was in love with it. I thought it was great. Opened up the windows and then got sick. So that's my problem.
Well, that's allergies. You just can't have windows open here.
No,
I go out and sit with the dog and I come back in the house and I'm miserable for the next hour.
Yeah, and that's about me, but not for an hour. But I learned the hard way, right?
Lisa just said, yay for the cameraman.
Yeah, I agree.
Those look good, Heather.
You okay, T? You just hit your head. All right, man down, man down.
I'm sorry, honey. He just said he couldn't get around me good.
No, I don't think it was that. He hit his head on the thing behind you.
Yeah, I heard that. I heard that thunk.
Is the wall okay? That's what I'm most worried about. Oh, you're great. I love you too, honey. I cannot move my brush. I'm painting. You'll have to wait.
Yesterday we had a really big wind move in, and we actually had dust storms, which is very unusual for this time of year.
Was it as bad over at your side as it was over here? We could not see that entire Superstition Mountain.
Saying, yeah.
It was a wall of not even gray. It was like a white.
Yeah.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say it was a snow blizzard.
Well, they usually start down south and work their way up, and by the time they get through the city of Phoenix and up to me, most of it has dissipated, you know, so we don't get as much dust, but we sure get the wind, and we still have dust, but that's so unusual for this time of year to have that.
I know, that's what I told Greg yesterday. I said it looked like monsoon season.
Uh-huh.
It really did.
Yeah, that is very
unusual. And tree parts down and everything, just like I'm used to in August. That was weird. That was weird, y'all.
And Lisa says to T-Dog, your mom is very blessed to have you in her corner, and that is so true.
That is very true. I hope that I mean, we joke around, you guys, and I hope that you realize that although yesterday, now this doesn't count because I've been under the sickness, right? When you're under the sickness, you can't be held responsible for your actions or your words. So yesterday aside, T-Dog, don't I usually say thank you? Yeah, he's not even going to talk to me. Yeah, we'll have to talk about that
Nikki
later.
Nikki lives south of here, and she said that her car was a brown mixed with rain.
Oh.
Which is the way it is. We get some of these really neat patterns. I took a picture of our car one time with this gorgeous rain and dust pattern on it that was just, it was like lace. It was so pretty.
Well, and that's the key, isn't it, though? We got to find the beauty in the ugly. I think that's really the key to life in general, not just, you know, a nasty storm that makes you feel like you're dying. You got to find the beauty in the ugly. Because we could all probably agree that there's plenty of ugly. We got lots of that. But the real trick is to find the beauty in it. And if we can do that, I think we can probably get away with just about anything. Get through anything for sure.
Oh, that's cool.
I don't know. What does that look like? Does that look all right? I do sort of feel like I need some orange in there for some reason, because it's just not. There we go. I don't know if any of this comes across on screen, these little subtleties that I add in here, but they matter in person, don't they? A little bit, Sylvia? Come on, just say yes for me, will you?
She's dipping into like her oranges and peaches and reds and stuff right now.
I can see it. Okay, that works. It sort of makes this feel like it's here and that's farther away.
Yeah, definitely.
All right.
Definitely more up front.
All right, let's get to laying in some of those in the back, because that's really where the fun is going to happen. Those purples and pinks back there are really going to be.
T-Dog, you are doing so good. He's doing great with adjusting the color, because this is perfect.
Looking spot on, huh? Yeah, he's paying attention to those color adjustments before he posts. So you might not get as many Instagram pictures today or as frequent, but they're going to be very high quality, it seems like. I can't wait to see them. I know you want to show me, bud, but I'm going to paint, okay? So you have more to take pictures of. All right, it's time to switch palettes. We're going to go into our purples and pinks over here. And start putting in some of those hoodoos in the back. Hoodoos? I didn't make the word up. It's really what they call these things, so there's nothing.
So when you were there, Heather, this just goes on, like, as far as the eye can see?
Oh, pretty much. It's so weird because you drive in and you're on this road. And, I mean, I'm not saying that the view isn't pretty, because it's beautiful. It's a state park or a national park, I mean. And it is beautiful the whole time you're driving around and going to look, you know. And then Greg pulls the motorhome into this spot where you can park. And then we all get out and walk over to the edge. And as you start getting closer to the edge, which is a ways away, you got to get out and walk, and there's a sidewalk and everything. And once you get up over that, all of a sudden it's like you just opened up a can. This huge, gigantic world just appears before you. And it has all of this, like, if I think I did take a panoramic, or tried to, it still didn't capture it all. I still didn't capture it all. For those of you who I shared that Google album, which if you're interested in that, I don't mind sharing that with folks. I just only shared it with people who said they were interested in it. But if that is something you're interested in, let me know in the contact us on the website, because then I can share it with you. I just need to have your, is it your email address or your Google account or something? I don't know. Somehow I need to be able to share it with you on Google Photos. If you don't use Google Photos, there's not really much I can do, because that's the only place I know how to share any kind of photos. But maybe I'll put it in the blog post when I do this. But anyway, I need to look and see if there's a, I can't paint and talk at the same time, but a panoramic of that picture. What an experience, though.
I'm looking at it. I'm trying to see if I can find it, too.
So somebody had a question a couple weeks ago, maybe, or maybe it was even asked after we were live. I don't remember. But I remember somebody saying, how do you mix, like, I think it was the picture that you took afterwards of the aftermath of what I do here, and it looks really gross. I mean, like, I'm putting all this color together.
Yeah.
And somebody was asking about how do you fix that? Like, you don't have any problem making your stuff dirty, basically. And then maybe they didn't even ask a question, but I wanted to kind of clarify that it's really simple to fix this. So I just take a
like
no, you don't want to blow on them. That was a mistake. But anyway, just facial tissue. Like, this is facial tissue. I don't think it has anything in it because I don't think we buy that kind, like lotion or anything. But I don't know if that would matter, but I would think probably, because you wouldn't want to put impurities into it. But
I don't think you'd want to put anything oily or anything
yeah.
like that. Yeah,
me neither. But just a light swipe of that, and it removes the color. So I don't know if you can see that, but I mean, it just fixes it, just like that. And it's same with the darker ones, the lighter ones, it doesn't matter. But now I need a drink of water. So now would be a good time for comments. Excuse me, guys.
Oh, my God. Yeah, you've got lots of pictures, I'm sure. Oh, yeah. Yes, you have a panorama. So your friend is here. And Mark is here. Hi, Mark. Aw. Do you have a throat lozenge or something? No.
Well, you just took that. I'll be a minute.
Okay. Do you want one of mine?
I'm sorry. I don't know if I'm still
on mic or not.
It doesn't take much for a little irritant to get into your throat down here and start these coughing jags. They're concerned that maybe it's from the dust when you wipe the...
No, it wasn't. It was starting before that, and I was trying to fight it.
Yeah, she's going to be okay.
I just took an inhaler. I should be ready. I just need a minute.
Mark is saying that he's been to Bryce Canyon and he loves it. I've never been. I think I owe it to myself to get up there.
Yeah, we should go on a
drive, Sylvia.
I did find Heather's panorama that she took of Bryce Canyon, of where she was standing in Bryce Canyon.
Oh, we got the comments on while I was choking to death.
Mm-hmm.
Do I have sound back on again, bud? Thank you. So sorry about coughing in your ear, you guys. All right, let's get back to painting.
Yes, she did. She went to the doctor and she got an allergy shot and she's 100% better than what she was.
I know. This really doesn't seem like it, though. I know, but honest to God, I'm better. I promise. All right, so let's just get in here and do some of this fun stuff in here. It doesn't look like much right now, but it will as we do the same thing that we did down here where we're going to add the greens of the grasses and trees and carve around some of these marks that we're making in here. And I'm going to use some of these purples and blues to do some of them. Instead of using the dark blacks like we did here, they're going to be more purple-blue to go in around.
It's a nice combination.
Isn't that neat? Look at how that does.
Mm-hmm.
Just no warning.
Oh,
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, that's just nuts. Thank you, Sylvia, for the throat lozenge. We'll see if that helps.
Oh. Aww. Mark just promoted, I'm not sure what all that means, but he says, miss being around for your show. Aw, that's sweet, Mark. Thank you.
Oh, my gosh. Super chat from Mark. Thank you, Mark. I miss you being around too, bud. I've been so busy trying to work my other job and trying to get healthy. Just trying to do preparations for our membership site and all. There's so many things going on behind the scenes that I don't get to see many of my friends much anymore. Even Sandra and Sylvia and I, who used to hang out to do our art hangouts like more regularly. Remember, we would do that like every week almost. Mm-hmm. We did get to do one last week, though. That was kind of nice. Okay, so T-Dog says, if the video seems like it's buffering, you might want to refresh your page. Also, there is a dial somewhere. That it looks like a cogwheel, and you can actually change the quality of the video. If you change the quality of the video, you won't see as much detail. But that's why we take those behind the scenes pictures, so you can see those a little bit better. When we're live streaming, the quality it just needs to be lower in order for the live stream to work. However, when you watch the replay. You could watch the replay in high quality, high definition, and it'll be great. So. We're red right now. So did, you're doing stuff on the phone.
Well, I was uploading the pictures, but I stopped, and I said, oh, there's red.
Yeah. That's.
And now it's continuing to be red.
Yeah. Okay.
BJ is so astute. It's really true. That cough would wear a person out. It does.
Oh, it does. It does. And I don't know if you guys remember, but Sylvia struggled with this. She struggles with this all the time. But there's been several episodes where we've had to, like, where did Sylvia go? And you're, like, muted, right? Yeah. I mean, you had the power of the mute button. Neither of us have that now.
Yeah.
So we're just, like, at the mercy of T-Dog to go, I'm dying! Mute! but yeah, anyway, so there's been plenty of episodes where I feel like she's left me, you guys. I don't know where she went. Oh, she just went to go hack herself to death. And it really is exhausting, and that's been my biggest problem. It isn't that, like, I feel bad, because I don't have flu symptoms. I don't have, you know, I'm tired and weak, and it's all because I have no sleep, because that thing happens to me all night long. But believe it or not, this is better, so.
Oh, Lisa had to leave us. I hope she can still hear us. Bye, Lisa. Thanks for joining us. Michael Ann says she wishes she had a painting buddy, but everyone she knows says, I can't, I don't know how.
Yeah, that's pretty common. Oh, geez, Louise, are you serious?
It's painting together when we hang out together and do stuff together. Yeah. That's what she means, is just, do you need another one, Heather? Another cocktail? No. Just, you know, hanging with somebody, whether you're like in a hangout or you're, you know, actually physically together, but somebody that just kind of, you can bounce ideas off of and stuff. It's a lot of fun. Like what we do, you know, when Heather and I hang out together on the, you know, hangouts and stuff.
Yeah.
It's okay, we can do that one. Yeah, she definitely has got a tickle in her throat right now. So sorry about that, guys. I don't know if you can hear outside, but she's just hacking up a lung. Oh. I think what we're going to do is we're going to end right here, because Heather's really, really having a hard time right now. And we'll be back next week to finish this, and we're going to have a special guest in the house here. And we look forward to everybody joining us back again so you can see this in completion. And thank you very much for your wonderful comments and for joining in. And, you know, share us. Share us all you can on all of the social medias that you have. We really, really would appreciate that. Thank you. See you next week, everybody.